This tutorial is about creating the appearance of straight lines using Snapseed's Perspective tool. Before we get started, I need to make it clear that some of the things I will demonstrate in this video are platform specific. There are currently some big differences between the way that the Perspective Repair tool that we have in Snapseed for Android and the Transform tool that we currently have in Snapseed for iOS devices functions. If you are trying to follow along with this lesson on an iOS device right now, you will have some, but not all of the features that I'm going to demonstrate. I have no doubt that the brilliant folks at Google will make these tools identical on both platforms soon. But for now, if you're on an iOS device, you can do most, but not all, of what I'm going to show today. To get started, I'm going to tap on that little pencil button down here in the bottom right to bring out Snapseed's Tools and Filters menu. This time, I'm going to dig right into the Perspective tool, which is super useful when repairing skewed images like this photo of the New York casino in Las Vegas. When the Perspective tool loads, you will see that there are four modes available here. Tilt allows us to shift the vertical or horizontal perspective of our image around. Rotate here functions much like the Rotate tool that I covered in a previous Snapseed tutorial. One difference that is worth mentioning here is that the Rotate mode inside of the Perspective tool does not include Snapseed's automatic straightening feature. But the Rotate mode in here is a useful option, as you will see once we start working on this image. Scale and Free are both modes for this tool that we don't have at this time on iOS devices. The Free Transform option is probably the most powerful choice in here, but I find it really hard to control this one with my fingertips, so I'm going to ignore it in this tutorial. Now, I picked this image to demonstrate what we can do with these tools because I think it illustrates a common frustration in mobile photography. All of the smartphones on the market today use some type of wide-angle lens. Our phones are wonderful little cameras, but all wide-angle lenses produce noticeable geometric distortion, especially when we are photographing something like a building, where the eye expects to see nice straight vertical lines. When you look at this image, do you see how the casino and the Statue of Liberty replica appear to be leaning back and bent away from the camera? Well, let's fix that by shifting things around using the Tilt Mode's Vertical Repair tool. If I slide my finger up or down across the screen, I can pivot this image around and make those buildings stand up straight. If I had slid my finger from right to left, instead, I could shift things around the horizontal axis rather than the vertical. I don't usually need that kind of repair, but it can be helpful, especially if you're working with a vertical rather than a horizontal original image. That's pretty slick, but there is something equally amazing going on here if you look close. Did you notice that as Snapseed skews this image around to make things nice and vertical, how it had to pinch one side of the image in and expand the other side out? Take a look at the dashed line around the edge of the photo. At the top of my frame, the image being pushed further out. In this case, that's fine since there was nothing of interest to see up there in the original sky. It's down at the bottom though, where the real magic is happening. Do you see how the dashed line angles in and away from the corners of the rectangle? When I shift the vertical perspective here, the lower right and lower left sides of this image no longer fill up the rectangular frame. Rather than leaving a hole or some empty space in those corners, Snapseed is inventing new pixels to fill up the frame. Watch those lower corners carefully as I change the perspective again. Did you see it that time? Did you see how there was a little pause and then Snapseed invented some pixels to fill up the dead space? In Adobe Photoshop, we would call what's happening here content-aware fill. Snapseed calls this feature smart fill mode. No matter what we call it though, it's amazing. Snapseed is trying to invent patches of pixels that blend seamlessly with the original photo so that my image remains a full frame rectangle. I think that Snapseed's Smart Fill did a great job here in the bottom right corner. I doubt that anyone would ever notice anything weird about the pixels that the program invented in the lower right without zooming in much closer and really looking for an abrupt edge. On the other side though, the plug of new pixels that Snapseed invented is not as convincing. The invented pixels in the lower left, the smart fill patch over there, just don't match up well with the original image. If I tap on the fill mode button, it turns out that we actually have a couple of options in here. If I don't want the smart fill active, I could tap on the fill with white or the fill with black options instead. I'm going to go with the fill with white option because it makes what's happening with our perspective changes the most obvious. Now, I'm going to return to the transform controls by tapping on the mode button. Just to demo now, I'm going to add a little more of the vertical perspective change. See how the area in white grows larger the more I shift the tilt around? Let me tap on the before after button so you can see where the image began again and where we are now. At this point, I think that I have done a good job fixing the vertical perspective problem, but the image still seems a little crooked. I'll tap on the rotate mode and try to get the horizon, in this case the line of the street, at the bottom of the picture nice and level. Notice how now I have some empty white space at the top right and the bottom left of the frame. If I were in the smart fill mode, then Snapseed would automatically try to cover those gaps with more invented pixels. But since smart fill is currently disabled, now we have two options. One option would be to commit our changes right now and then go into the crop tool and cut away all that empty white space. Sometimes cropping further into your image is the best solution after this kind of heavy perspective correction. But there is one other thing that we could try here first. If I tap on the scale mode button down there on the toolbar, then this tool will change again and I'll have some new options. Think of scale mode as a stretching tool. If I drag my finger up or down on the screen now, I can stretch or shrink this image. In this case, I'm going to drag down to make the image taller until all that empty white space at the top is gone. Now, I need to be careful not to go too far. I don't want the Empire State Building replica here to touch the top of the frame. But scaling things up a bit can hide the empty space at the top, and it can create the appearance of even taller buildings. If I drag my finger from right to left in scale mode, I can expand or contract the width of this image. In this case, scaling things out horizontally does a great job eliminating the areas that would need to be filled or cropped away along the sides of my image. Double bonus, scaling things horizontally also pushed that annoying street light that I didn't really want in my image off the far right side of the frame. Let me tap on the before after button once more, so you can see what an amazing difference we have made here. I'm going to click on the check mark in the bottom right to commit my perspective changes and to return to Snapseed's main screen. I could certainly call it quits at this point and press the save button up there at the top, but I think I'm going to cut away a little bit of the right side of the image now using the crop tool. When the crop tool loads, I think I'll tap on the aspect ratio button and then on the original option so that I'm not changing the shape of the rectangle that my smartphone created when I shot this photo. Now, I'll drag the crop frame in from the top right corner. I think I'll also bring the crop in a bit from the bottom to hide some of that distracting stuff that we don't need to see along that edge of this image. Now I'm really happy. I'll commit the crop with the check mark button again on the toolbar. Now I'm ready to save my work and call this image perfect. I'm going to press and hold one finger against the main screen here once more so that you can see the complete before and after for this image. From this to this. Wow.